We're starting on the body. I decided to use the forward jaw. They wanted me to mount all this and mount it on the tool post and do the boring and everything, kind of, and line bore it and all that. I'm just going to face this off and drill it and bore it. I think we'll be just fine, Andy. I have a really good I have a good boring bar, so that should come out just fine. What I did is here, now I have copper disc in between here. My jaws are pretty aggressive on this four jaw. Quick, instead of having soft jaws necessarily, it goes around, go around there, you know, like these. And these ones are kind of thin for doing this, because you can see how they've been beat up a little bit. Take a piece of copper pipe, 3/4, 1 inch, or even 1/2 inch. Cut a ring off of it, and then just pound it flat. Cut the ring, pound it flat, and it comes out nice thick. And you can make them any width you want, just how wide you cut the ring off, and just pound them flat. They make great little, soft jaw spacers. Here, I used a piece of 1 inch pipe and clamped them in there. Nice and thick, won't damage your stock. And pretty consistent on the thickness. So you can see here I set the dowel indicator up, measured me and just measured back and forth till I got it centered up. I'm within a thousandth to less than a thousandth each way on all four ways. So we're ready to face this off and start drilling and boring. 3/4 inch bore. See there how these are placed in the jaws, just to, if you're curious, how they're just pinched between there. This works really well. Here's our drawing, just to give you an update here. So here's our picture, here's our bore. We have 3 tapped holes for that, the first piece to be bolted onto. Then we have another hole on up here, and that's just a oil.
RPM.
There you go, squared up. Now the stock is extra long. I think it's about 1/4 inch extra in length. I'm using a 3/8 spotting drill.
I'm set up with a 23/32 drill, so that should give me enough room to get my 5/8 boring bar in there.
I have my 5/8 solid carbide boring bar in here, and we're at 707, we want 750. I'm just gonna skim it and see if we can make sure it's straight. We're gonna take off another 10 total here. We're at 728, so we have 22 thousandths to go. And we're measuring maybe 1/1000th difference between each end, and that or a little less. It's not much. So I'm gonna take another 10 off total, maybe a little more. That bore looks really nice, just so you know. It's all the way down, and yeah, looks really good. Let's see what we are at the end here. 739. Now down deep, it's really, this is really hard to do. You're running in there all the way. Tighten it. And then try to flip it. But before I had 739.1, and now I have 739.4, so
just a few tenths difference. That's pretty good. This is my plug gauge. So this is on size 750. One under, one over. And so of course that should not fit, and it doesn't, which is a good sign. So I'm thinking of reaming it, but that finish is so nice in there. A reamer doesn't necessarily make the finish that much better.
Yeah, I just had to ream it the rest of the way. We have 10 thousandths. So let's use our 3/4 reamer. Got a lot of oil here on it. Ream through. Let's try the gauge in there. Oh, okay, that fits pretty easily. Oh, the over one fits. And I mean, it just fits, but so I'm a little on the big side. Yeah, that's what happens with reamers. You never know sometimes. Well, we'll make this work. Bronze material, then I can make special bushings for that if I have to. Okay, well, here's the oil light bushing supposed to go in there. Sure slips in easy, and it's got a little wiggle room. I don't particularly care for that. I have some 1¼ oil light stock here. I might even order a smaller piece. We'll see what I want to do there. Turn all that material down. I think I'm gonna make some bushings that will fit a lot better than that. I'll keep the hole, but maybe even make it a tiny bit larger. But it measures, has a few thousandths of taper actually, so I don't like what the reamer did. I might bore it because I can get a lot of straighter hole. I might rebore that, and I'll make maybe make some new bushings. I decided I'm just gonna make new bushings to fit this, so I've ordered some stock. I'm going to bore that so it's nice and straight, because there's about 5 thousandths difference now. And then we'll call it good so I can make some bushings for it. Took it out of the chuck. We have about 1/1000th of taper differential on either end. I'll make new bushings for it. I ordered some material. We need to drill some holes in it and do all that anyway. We'll do that next. Well, this is the body. We're back to that. In the previous part, when I bored that, I reused a reamer and it oversized it. So, for these bushings. So I bored it a little bit bigger even. So that, you know, these obviously go right through. These are the ones that came with the kit. And I picked up a chunk of oilite bronze there. And we just make some new bushings for it. They'll be a little oversized, but they'll be just fine. So we're just going to make some new bushings for this so we can proceed. Must have about 30,000 run out, it looks like.
It's got quite the Yahoo in it.
Not
too bad. I think I'm a tenth off. Okay. We'll get that board out. Here's the shaft that needs to go in there, and here's the original bushing, and that fits really, really nice. I'm going to drill it with a half inch drill, and then we'll bore it. I changed boring bars. That other one has a bit of a radius on the insert, and I want a sharp point, so I put this little short carbide one I have in, and I'm just going to bore one bushing at a time that way to the proper length. I'll have a better control of the size. I just did two roughing cuts, and this is should be my final. Oh. Piston fit there. It's perfect. And we'll just break the edges, part it off. Forgot I have to turn the OD. We only have to take off the 45 thousandths. So we'll do a little calibration cut and then go from there. Wow, I was shooting for 8042 or 3. What luck. Anyway, let's see. That's now pressing awful tight if that. Yeah. I'm just going to dress that a little bit with a file so it just goes in nice. We're going to leave it right there, park that off. That's good for that one. And nice bushing. We'll just pop it back in the chuck after we take that out and clean that end off. Bushing number two, and we're piston fit again. Just
actually, this is just perfect.
Alright, I just kind of got them stuck in there, and the shaft slides just perfect in there. So we'll probably press those in, and hopefully they'll be nice and straight still. If we have to give a little more clearance, then we'll just set it back up and run a boring bar through, clean them up. So here, that's how I'm going to put it in. I got the shaft in there, right? And I pushed them in with my hand, and then I'm just tapping them in with the shaft in there. Soft hammer. Till they're flush. And see if I can get my shaft moves, it's snug. Snug's better than loose. Flushed it up. It's snug, but that's better than loose. That won't take much to clean up. Can't push it with my hand, but we'll knock her out of there, and maybe I'll just do a, I don't know what I'll do. I'll just do a little cleanup on it. So I cleaned up the end of the shaft, which had a little bit of a burr, and when the sawing or flaring or something, a little bit on the ends. And I did a real quick little polish actually on it. So that is, that fits all the way in there. Nice turns, zero play. But a little drop of oil on there would be just fine. Anyway, this is just a hand thing anyway, so no play is good. Love it.